Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Bill Cosby. Elvis closed last night. I'm a little lighter skinned than you thought I was. And I don't have a natural light like I do on my TV show, you know. Me and old Harold. I mean, not Harold. What's his name? Albert. Fat Albert. Hey. Hey, look. Somebody gave me this thing here. Yeah, it really is. Somebody gave it to me. And I just got an 8th degree black belt in karate. After 16 years of doing this art every day for 16 years, I was awarded the 8th degree, which carries it. Let's see, 8th degree. There's only 10 degrees of black. So the 8th degree I just got this week. The 9th degree carries senior master of the art, the next one. And the 10th is senior grandmaster of the art. So that's where I got to strive to go to, which takes quite a while, isn't it? Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like you to meet one of the fellows who promoted me to the 8th degree black. His name is Ed Parker. He has about 18 Kenpo schools around the country. Ed Parker. There's another fellow in the audience. See that book. This friend of mine, his name is John O'Grady. He's written a book. He was head of the narco squad in Los Angeles for 26 years. And on the 166th page, he's got about 3 pages about me and my ex-wife, Priscilla, and about our friendship, and about that maternity suit. It turned out to be a complete conspiracy and a hoax, man. And I just, no way. I had a picture made with that chick, and that's all. I mean, she got pregnant with a camera, a Polaroid or something. Anyway, it's all in this book. It's the most... been watching Polaroid cameras, water. But you know what she did? And when she goofed up, she named the night. And the night that she named, my wife was with me in the audience. And that's the night she said, "Ain't no way I'm gonna fool around with her out there. You kidding me?" So anyway, let me tell you something. If you like things like the French Connection, the Chinese Connection, the British Connection, the knee connection to the jump bone, if you like that type of stuff, buy this book. It's called O'Grady. It'll be in print when, John? Up to September 27th. It will fascinate you. It's about 26 years of a hardline policeman working in the narco squad out of Hollywood. So you can imagine what it's like. By this book, it's called O'Grady. Okay. John just came back from New York, where he had a meeting of this. I have been a member of this organization for 5 years, the International Narcotics Enforcement Officers Association. In recognition of the outstanding loyalty and contribution to the support of narcotic law enforcement, this award of special honor is bestowed upon Elvis Presley in testimony, so-and-so, lifetime member in the International Narcotics Enforcement Officers Association. So I just got that. So, I don't pay attention to rumors. I don't pay attention to movie magazines. They don't read them because they're all junk. No, I don't mean to put anybody's job down. I'm talking about they have a job to do, and they got to write something. So if they don't know anything, they make it up, you know. So in my case, they make it up. When I hear rumors flying around, I got sick in the hospital. Well, I was, you know, in this day and time, you can't even get sick. You are strung out. Well, by God, I'll tell you something, friend. I have never been strung out in my life except on music. When I got sick here in the hotel, I got sick here that one night. I had 102 temperature. They wouldn't let me perform. From three different sources, I heard I was strung out on heroin. I swear to God, hotel employees, Jack, bellboys, freaks that carry your luggage up to the room, people working around, you know, talking, maids. And I was sick. I was, you know, I was getting, had a doctor, had the flu, and I got over one day. But all across this town, I was strung out. So I told him earlier, and don't you get offended, ladies and gentlemen, I'm talking to somebody else. If I find or hear the individual that has said that about me, I'm going to break your goddamn neck, you son of a bitch. That is dangerous. That is damaging to myself, to my little daughter, to my father, to my friends, my doctor, to everybody, my relationship with you, my relationship with up here on the stage. It is dangerous. I will pull your goddamn tongue out by the roots. Thank you very much. Anyway, how many of you people saw the movie Blue Hawaii? Probably the most requested song. Let me get out of this mood. Probably the most requested song in the movie was the Hawaiian wedding song. So let me do that for you. This is the moment I've waited for. I can hear my heart singing.
Blah, 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 blah.
Soon we'll be ringing. This is the moment, love, sweet hello. I will love you longer and forever.
That's beautiful, honey. Thank you.
Promise me that you.
I take this and I'm strung out.
Honey, you don't mind if I use it to show it, do you? All my love. Promise me that you will leave me never. I will love you long and forever. Now that we are one, clouds won't hide the sun. Blue skies, a Hawaii smile on this our wedding day. I do love you, with all my Hawaii.
Thank you.